this?
What is it?
Hamas's attack on southern Israel on October 7th was unprecedented for the group in its planning and scale. It was an unexpected demonstration of the military expertise it has gained since seizing control of Gaza in 2007. A senior Hamas official, Ali Baraka, recently said that the group had long drawn on money and training from Iran and Iranian regional proxies like Lebanon's Hezbollah while bolstering its own forces in Gaza. Baraka said that over the past 9 years, Hamas developed its capabilities to manufacture weapons locally as it faced difficulties in importing weapons. He added that in the 2008 Gaza war, Hamas rockets had a maximum range of 40 kilometers, but that had risen to 230 kilometers by the 2021 conflict. News agency Reuters conducted interviews with 11 people familiar with the group's capabilities, including Hamas figures, regional security officials, and military experts. According to the information gathered by Reuters, today Hamas is unrecognizable from the small Palestinian group that issued its first leaflet 36 years ago protesting an Israeli occupation. An anonymous source close to Hamas in the Gaza Strip called Hamas a mini army. He said that the group had a military academy training, a range of specializations including cybersecurity, and boasts a naval commando unit among its 40,000 strong military wing. According to a website on global security, in the 1990s, Hamas had less than 10,000 fighters. According to a regional security source, since the early 2000s, the group has built a tunnel network under Gaza to help fighters melt away, house weapons factories, and bring in weapons from abroad. Hamas officials have said that the group has acquired a range of bombs, mortars, rockets, anti-tank, and anti-aircraft missiles. The expanding capabilities have produced increasingly lethal results over the years. Israel lost 9 soldiers during its incursion in 2008. In 2014, the number jumped to 66. Hamas, whose 1988 founding charter called for Israel's destruction, is classified as a terrorist organization by Israel, the United States, the European Union, Canada, Egypt, and Japan. The idea of Hamas, which means zeal in Arabic, began to take form on December 10th of 1987. Some members of the Muslim Brotherhood convened the day after an Israeli army truck crashed into a car carrying 4 Palestinian day workers, killing all of them. Stone-throwing protests, strikes and shutdowns in Gaza followed. They met at the house of a Muslim cleric named Sheikh Ahmed Yassin. There, they decided to issue a leaflet on December 14th, calling for resistance as the first intifada or uprising against Israel erupted. It was the group's first public act. Western intelligence sources have said that after Israel withdrew from Gaza in 2005, Hamas began importing rockets, explosives, and other equipment from Iran. They added that weapons were shipped via Sudan, trucked across Egypt, and smuggled into Gaza through a labyrinth of narrow tunnels beneath the Sinai Peninsula. The group's leaders are spread across the Middle East in countries including Lebanon and Qatar, but its power base remains Gaza. The sources Reuters spoke to said that while Iran trained, armed and funded the group, there was no indication that Tehran directed or authorized the October 7th attack. Iran acknowledges it helps finance and train Hamas but has denied a role in the attack, although it praised it. Last year, Hamas leader Ismail Haniyeh said that this group had received $70 million in military help from Iran. According to a US State Department report from 2020, Iran provides about $100 million annually to Palestinian groups including Hamas, Palestinian Islamic Jihad and the Popular Front for the Liberation of the Palestine General Command. An Israeli security source said that Iran had significantly increased funding for Hamas's military wing in the past year from $100 million to about $350 million a year.
Subscribe to One India channel and never miss an update.